Please, Ton, could you share with us some of your cases so that people can see how do you think about the case when you are applying the HDT?
This is a case. Of course, I'm very happy that I can share these cases. This is a case about a guy who has a company who decorate walls. And he came in 2008 to me, and then he was 35 years old with a bacteria infection in his right knee, and he had a lot of complaints and antibiotics for it, and nothing helped. So he must stop with his job. He liked his job and he don't want to stop. So he came because of his friend was treated by me well. So he wanted to treat also. And he tells about his life, and I take all the symptoms and I did my repertorization and I find causticum. First, I gave Ladem because of the acute situation he came, very swollen knee and itching pain. So I give Ladem 3 times a day, 200, 3 days after each other, and 1 time a day, Hypericum. He cured very quickly. The infection goes, but the pain in his knee stays. It was stiffness of his knee. So I give him causticum because of also the mental issues. It was very quick cured without any problem. But after 2 years, he came back because he had other complaints and antibiotics again. He came with a complaint of colitis ulcerosis, a very bad situation because every stool 4 or 5 times a day with clots of blood and lots of pain in his stomach. I thought, what I must do now? And I gave him magnesium phosphoricum and it helps him. But every time it comes back. And then I decide to give him a gluten course because he is allergic about gluten intolerance.
You mean various potencies of gluten?
Yes, different. Yes. He get a course 44, and on Saturday carcinogenum cancuprum because he was very in touch with his family, very nice behaving, but he comes from a family with very bad situation because they have brokers. They drink a lot of alcohol, a lot of amphetamines and other drugs. So he was the only one who don't use these things for the last 20 years. I give him the gluten course with carcinogenum on the Saturday and causticum once in the week. And he becomes much better after 4 weeks. So he get an 8-week course, and after 4 weeks, become much better. And we wait for a while to see what happens. And then everything come back. And he gets from me glucose again with causticum on the Saturday because his causticum issue was very clear there. But he was also by the internist and they did research and they want to give him a lot of allopathic medicines like Cytofolk and prednisone, but he don't want that. He don't take this stuff because he trusts homeopathy very well. And he did with a trial with another 35 people, also with colitis ulcerosis. And after the gluten course, still for a while, it was much better than before the gluten course, but it was not cured. So I say question to the specialist and I ask him, is it possible that we do a test about bacteria in his stool or in his stomach? So, and the results of the examination of the stool was that he had Helicobacter stool. So he got the antibiotic don't do anything. So he got from me an antibiotic course together with a Helicobacter course. And after that course from 8 weeks, because we did it both together, and on Saturday causticum again, and on the end of the course he was totally cured.
What did you do different in comparison with the typical classical homeopathic approach in this case?
What I did, I take away the energy of gluten out of his body, so his body can react normal. And I give the picture with the homeopathic medicine like Helicobacter to cure the marrow of the energy of Helicobacter in his system. Mm-hmm. So the Helicobacter, there was no room for it, so it disappeared from his cell.
And you gave as well antibiotics?
Yes, that is to make the immune system stronger and the environment in the bowels better. So there is a balance, like what you can do also with the bowel nozotes. But in his case was antibiotica with the Helicobacter and the causticum, a beautiful solution for it. It solved totally his problem. From now, it is nearly 5 years ago, and still I see him because he wants to talk with me about anthroposophy and other things, and sometimes he get a remedy to support his mental thing. So sometimes I be his mental coach. And that's it. He is healthy and he loves his life, works again.
So if you didn't know about homeopathic detox therapy, maybe you would apply just a causticum or what, and what would be the result?
The result was that I must give him until the end of his life causticum in different kinds of attentions every time.
And because you mentioned about gluten, did he as well got because a diet of gluten free?
His situation become worse when he eats grains like wheat.
So when you gave him gluten, after this, was he able to eat food which contains gluten, or you advised him to get a diet?
Advise him to take spelt, and after the spelt and the gluten course, and in spelt is also include gluten. So it is not so that people who have an allergy for gluten that they can stand wheat and also spelt. They did the research with 35 patients with colitis ulcerosis, and he was one of them. And he don't use allopathic medicines, only homeopathic in the trial. He was the only one from the 35 who cleared for 100%.
No blood in the stool.
Yep. Everything, his energy level is good. No joint problems anymore. He's very healthy.
Did you as well give him some physical probiotics or enzymes or something like this?
What I did is give him ascorbate complex with potassium, zinc, magnesium. It did him very well. And also with extra zinc to support his system to get released of heavy metals. Nothing more. A good food advice. Always I give this to people. I have a case about a guy who has very bad behaving problems. He is 38 years old with his first visit. One of his years, he was ADHD. On the primary school, he had all problems with concentration, but not violent problems. Now he is violent against his wife. He's visited me because his wife said to him, "You must go to him because I'm not able to love you anymore with such a behaving." He's a truck driver. He has bad concentration, a lot of irritations on the road, but never he had accidents. Before he came to me, he was go to the psychologist with concentration problems, and he get 4.5 years methylphenidate. Because of that, he went very unhappy, very busy in his mind. And because of that, the psychologist gave him Statira. In the first half year, it goes very good with him. But now he need more of Statira every day because he get on the end of the day a relapse. He start again shouting and become angry, and his rebounds came very bad every day after a half year. Then he said to me, "The Statira make me a murder weapon." His wife sit next to him in the concert and she's crying, and she said, "I love him very much, but I can't fed on this manner. He betrayed me, and when he is angry from out of nothing, he throw the distance toy for the television to my head and S secret box to my head. So I'm afraid of him. He betrayed me with other woman. And before the Stratera, he was more lovely, more gently. So I love him very much. I want my husband back without all the complaints." I give him, after this consultation, Androctonus. You know this medicine?
Androctonus, yes. Scorpio.
Yes. In between 24 hours, he was quiet. He has an empty head, no sorrows in his mind. Not angry anymore. But after 3 days, he ring me and he said, "Everything's come back. What we can do?" And then I decide to give a detox for Stratera. There's a very bad medicine like methylphenidate, but more stronger and more worse are for the brain and for the serotonin in the system. And on the Saturday, he get Adactonus. So this is what his main remedy was,
constitutional.
Yes. I did the course, and what's come, he become more calmer, more concentrated, everything goes well. And his wife decide to have another child with him. They have one child, and she don't want more child because of his behaving. But now she said, "I'm ready for the second child." And now he's very healthy without any problem. Because in the past he had no allopathic medicines, only methylphenidate, and a few times in his total life antibiotics. But he had a good stool, no stomach problems and gut problems. So he was very healthy before, only he had the ADHD. That was his problem, but he could do his job very well.
In your courses, you are often using and telling about some remedies which people usually don't use. Remedies like for example, Papa Vera Roa, like the body substances. You have a lot of experience with these body substances. Maybe you can tell us something about this.
That's because I'm never satisfied. There must be a possibility for every patient to cure. And sometimes there is a disbalance in hormones or enzymes or bacteria or white blood cells or vitamins or minerals. And we can solve this problem with the homeopathic remedy to make a new balance. And I found out that we have a protocol about different levels of diseases, and it is necessary to start with a good level. So we have a hierarchy about allopathic medicines and minerals and gases and so on. And we have also the layer about organs and systems. And I make this clear for understanding in every seminar I give, so that people can understand what I'm doing.
So basically there are some rules in treating people according to the levels in the human system and the hierarchy of the various substances which the patient has taken before coming to you.
Yes, I need to have blood research from them. Most of them have them already. I need to have the schedule of allopathic medicines. They have, if it's possible, the whole life, but if otherwise, from the last years. In Holland, the pharmacy has the duty to give the list of all the allopathic medicines.
Mm-hmm. And what can you say to people who have been to the courses of CIS therapy and they have studied this method? In which way is your course useful for them? How can they benefit by attending your course?
There's a big difference between CIS and HDT, because the HDT is not only for autistic spectrum. It's all kinds of diseases, from infection even to cancer. This is a great possibility to cure all mankind. And that's the difference with CIS. CIS has no hierarchies. They start with detox from the last to the beginning of allopathic medicines or vaccinations and so on.
Which
that's the difference.
Bring some aggravations?
They have aggravations. We have nearly no aggravations.
This is because people, before starting the treatment, they must be acquainted with the hierarchy of the substances, like
yes,
allopathic medicines, and the hierarchy of the systems and organs in the body.
Described it very beautiful. So we can use the organon for this. This method is the same, but in a new code, you can say.
Mm-hmm.
Because everything is there. But we live in the age of 2000 and not a 1900 century anymore.
In HDT, you are introducing some new remedies which are not used in CIS therapy. Like which ones?
Like Diecoveries fallosa, camphora, umbilium cord, like vitamin B6 and B12, and a lot more allopathic medicines.
And for me, it is very interesting that you are using body substances like bilirubin, like
serotonin,
cholesterol, serotonin, etc., etc., and as well hormones which are produced by the human body, like progesterone, mm-hmm. adrenaline, etc. This is something which is different with CIS therapy, or not?
Yes, that is very different, and it works very balancing in the system.
You are not only detoxing, but you are as well introducing a new balance in the organism.
Yes.
By using some of the substances which the body produces, but in a potentized form. So
yes.
Are you going to give during
like a case like too much testosterone or a too low level testosterone? You can give testosterone, because testosterone as homeopathic remedy make balance. So a homeopathic remedy is always bringing balance. If you have a leak on arsenicum, you need arsenicum. If you have too much, you must have arsenicum.
Yes.
A lot of homeopathing, there is no possibility for a leak of arsenicum. But there is, because you have numbness, because we need arsenicum.
In the course, you are going to give as well the materia medica of these new remedies which you are talking about. Because I know
yes.
that you are writing a book about this. Are
yes.
you going to share this during the course now or what?
Yes, of course. I share this part of human body substances in the course with the pictures of them, so that you can understand, that the patients show them, that you can find it without blood results. The best is, if it is possible, that you have the blood results as well.
But still there are some symptoms and there are some ways to find out which body substance is out of balance by the symptoms of the patient, and you
yes.
can introduce these body symptoms. Is it something which is a substituent of, for example, for the women, let's say, instead of sepia, you can give progesterone or what?
Progesterone, we can give even also testosterone on ladies, because sometimes they have a too high level, so they can be pregnant because of that. We can give all kinds of estrogen, we can give the saliva or vagina fruit. We have a lot of possibilities to give.
So you are producing, with the help of the Hahnemann Apotheke, new remedies for the homeopathic community.
Yes, the last year I have more than 80 new remedies.
Are there some connection between some plant remedies, like, for example, there are some liver remedies like lycopodium or chelidonium or whatever, and then instead of them you can give like maybe cholesterinum or bilirubinum or something like this? Or do you use them together or how?
I can use them together. Like when somebody has a high level of bilirubin, you can give chelidonium. But if you give the substance bilirubin, it is much quicker than chelidonium.
And this is not isopathy because?
It's not isopathy because Hahnemann used the same with people who used arsenicum or mercury or other chemicals. He used also, you can say, isopathy, but it isn't because it is a potentized form.
Basically, people now think wrongly that arsenicum was used by Hahnemann because of some abstract similarity with the symptoms, which was not the case because basically in this time, they were using arsenicum everywhere. It was a common poison, a common toxin.
Yes. Yeah?
The same you can say about mercury and about aurum and about argentum.
Yes. They work with the stuff and they come in contact with the stuff in the food, in their work, so they get big problems.
In a way, he was detoxifying their bodies with these substances.
Yes.
Have you come across from Hahnemann with some sorts of courses he gave, like one potency, then another potency, then a third one? Or this is something which you, from your experience, you introduced?
Yes, that's from my experience. I find out that Tau K is also a beautiful, and sometimes 6K will do his job. It depends on which substances. And I explain why I take for one patient this and for the other patient that. That I explain on the seminar.
You know my attitude towards what you do. I feel that this is a real revolution in homeopathy, in contemporary homeopathy. And I think that it is something unprecedented. Before you, it was not done in this way. Some people have done something about this, but you go very deep into this. And I want to endorse your course and advise everybody who has not been with you and who has not seen your teaching to come and to enjoy and to just to relax and within couple of days, maybe within one or two seminars, the eyes of the new student will open and he will start to understand things which he was not able to understand before this. And here is the place to say that I am very impressed and very thankful, and my practice has changed forever after we met each other and after I had this opportunity to work with you. And I very much I like and I enjoy the cases which we take together, because there are other colleagues which are present and they can ask you questions and you can explain many things after you was asked a question. So I advise the people who will attend your course to ask you many questions. It goes very good in this way.
I'm always happy with questions. They must have patience to get the question on the right time in the seminar. So sometimes I say, wait a while, because the time comes and then I ask you again. So every question is necessary. There are no stupid questions.
Is it so that people first must have a good, solid, basic knowledge of homeopathy?